Hello everyone, it's Gladius. So in Season 2, we're going to be working with a new item called the Spark of Shadowflame. This might sound a little bit familiar to you if you participated at all in the first season. This one is going to help you upgrade past the item level gate that the Spark of Ingenuity gave us. It's basically going to mark your crafting item as a Season 2 crafted item. Now something nice about this is you can actually change the spark that's in your item from a Spark of Ingenuity into a Spark of Shadowflame. I'm going to show you how to do that. And also I'm going to show you exactly where you can get your Sparks of Shadowflame each week. This is the major part of player progression that we want to make sure we're taking advantage of, and all of our characters that were progressing through Season 2 completing this weekly activity to make sure they get their Spark of Shadowflame. There's a lot to cover, so let's get right into it. The importance of crafting makes a major return in Season 2 of Dragonflight. Not only are we able to craft items that have higher item levels, but we're also going to have to use crests that are made by enchanters to be able to increase the possible item level that our items are able to expand to. The key to getting an item that has access to these higher item level gates is going to be tied to our progression with how many Sparks of Shadowflame we have. So the first thing I want to go over is how to get your Spark of Shadowflame each week. Then I want to go over what it's like to craft with Sparks of Shadowflame from a crafter's perspective. And then I want to go over what it's like from any player's perspective that's looking to recraft their gear. We're able to get each one of these on a weekly basis, except for the first week here, where we're able to get 2 splinters to be able to make a Spark of Shadowflame in our very first week. Well, for getting the ball rolling this week, look no further than Examiner Tayshara Bloodwatcher. This character is going to be positioned in Loam. You're able to see her just north of the renowned vendors in the weekly quest. Examiner Tayshara is going to have a quest called Power United. It's important we get this quest first and also get it in tandem with another quest that's going to be our weekly wrapper quest called A Worthy Ally Loam Niffen. We can get that from Mimup. This is a very key part of the process because this is not a campaign mission, so you won't be forced to pick this one up as you're progressing the story content. Make sure you pick this up from Mimup. Otherwise, you will be grinding out the renown through world quests, elite farming, and things like that. So just make sure that you pick up this quest from Mimup and you have a worthy ally where you have to get 1500 renown with the Niffen faction. Now let's take a look at the rewards that you're able to get from completing this. You're going to get something called a splinter of this Shadowflame spark. This splinter can be combined with another splinter for you to be able to make a spark of Shadowflame. Yes, so on a weekly basis, we're going to get 1 splinter. So that's half of a spark, meaning every 2 weeks we'll have a full spark. Now the way you get the second spark for your first week is you can head on over to collect that Power United quest. And then upon completion of the Loam Niffen quest, the Worthy Ally Loam Niffen quest, you're going to be able to just walk over and turn in this quest to get a second spark. The only requirement of this quest is just to go ahead and get a splinter, and then she'll just give you a second splinter for having a splinter. So the main objective is just completing that wrapper quest, and then you'll be able to get your second spark easily by turning in this quest over here. Now, let's talk about how we can use our sparks. I want to use a weapon as an example. So if I wanted to upgrade my old weapon from last season, so once I pull it up on the Recraft, you can see that I have a bunch of things attached to it already, including the Spark of Ingenuity. Now the Spark of Ingenuity means that it's going to cap out at a 395 item level. Now if we can go ahead and right click on our Spark of Ingenuity, it's going to ask if I want to replace my Spark of Ingenuity, and then it will be destroyed upon recrafting. That's not a big deal, at least it isn't to me, because this item level is going to be very low compared to what we can find in Season 2. So I'm going to go ahead and accept this. Now first of all, I'm talking about a two-handed item. Two-handed weapons are going to require 2 sparks. If you're using a one-hander, or if this is going on a necklace or something like that, any of your spark items, then it's usually going to take just 1. Now, after clicking on the spark, you're able to choose your base of if you want to start with a Spark of Ingenuity or if you want to start with a Spark of Shadowflame. Of course, I don't have 2 sparks just yet because we're capped at just a splinter each week. So if you're also doing a two-hander like I am, you're going to have to wait 2 more weeks to be able to craft your spark weapon. Now, next, let's talk about the optional reagents, because there are some changes here. First of all, the seared alloy and that kind of stuff is going to stay the same. But down here, we can change from a primal infusion to something else once we're working with our Spark of Shadowflame. Just to show you how this works, notice that when I hover over my primal infusion, it says it requires a Spark of Ingenuity. That's because the primal infusion and also the concentrated primal infusion are both season 1 enhancers for your gear. these are not going to apply to any Spark of Shadowflame item anymore. Once you change the Spark of Shadowflame, you're only able to use an Enchanted Worm's Shadowflame Crest or an Enchanted Aspect's Shadowflame Crest. Notice the item level gate is going to be for an item that's champion or higher. Those are the item levels that you're going to see in champion gear here or hero gear. Now, something to notice is that if we look at the Enchanted Aspect's Shadowflame Crest, we're actually able to upgrade the item all the way up to 447. The highest item level that you can find in mythic content is going to be 441. This means that actually to get our highest item level gear, the highest item level gear can be attained through crafting. Now, just to cover everything else, the rest of the optional reagents are all the same from before, and the finishing reagents are also the same as well. If you're curious about any of those and how you can maximize your crafts and make really strong items, go ahead and take a look at my guide in the description where I go over how the optional reagents and finishing reagents can influence the outcome of your craft. All right, I wanted to go through an example as if I was a player wanting to upgrade my elemental lariat from a Spark of Ingenuity Season 1 piece to a Season 2 Spark of Shadowflame piece. So first thing you need to do is head on over to the Crafting Order Station. It's just right here in the Artisan's Market. And then first thing you're gonna need to do is you need to make a Shadowflame Crest. Depending on the type of content you're progressing through, you would pick one of these. So this would be the middle level. This is gonna be equivalent to kind of like champion level, item level. You would make a crafting order for the Shadowflame Crest. Notice that there is a required reagent on here, the Worm's Shadowflame Crest. This is going to be the player progression piece that we get from the dungeon. Remember, about 15 fragments are going to drop from the end of Mythic Plus dungeons. If you're curious about how to acquire these, take a look at my guide in the description. I go over in detail about where you can get your Shadowflame Crest so you can target farm these. But once again, these are a required reagent. This basically ensures that we've completed content that's deserving of that item level quality of gear. And then after we make this and send this crafting order out, then at that point we can start our recrafting order. Go ahead and select our lariat. And then we can change from a Spark of Ingenuity over to the Spark of Shadowflame. Notice that that alone is going to increase our item level. But if we wanted to infuse it with power further than that, we could then apply either an Enchanted Worm's Shadowflame Crest or an Aspect's Shadowflame Crest. Depending on the one we just made with our crafting order, we would then apply that, and then that would increase our item level even further. But for just getting started, if you don't have all those items, you could always recraft again later and just get the item level bonus of just crafting it with a Spark of Shadowflame, because it is gonna jump up from 495 up to the 411. If you don't already have your neck piece at that level. One more thing, notice that there is no quality attached to the Shadowflame Crests, so you're fine to make this a public order if you would like, or you can make it a personal order. It's up to you on that. It's not gonna be better or worse if it's made by a lower or higher level enchanter. All right, that's everything we need to know about the Spark of Shadowflame. If there's any updates to the system or anything added in the future, I'll go ahead and release another video about it. However, if this video helped you out today, please rogue strike that like button. And if you want to stay tuned for more WoW content in the future, please slam the subscribe. Thank you for your time, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, everyone.